हेलो फ्रेंड्स, द फिजिक्स कोचिंग में आपका स्वागत है। हम पढ़ रहे हैं न्यूक्लियर फिजिक्स। न्यूक्लियर फिजिक्स की ये तीसरी क्लास है। इस क्लास की पीडीएफ आप हमारे टेलीग्राम ग्रुप से प्राप्त कर सकते हैं। टेलीग्राम ग्रुप की लिंक आपको डिस्क्रिप्शन में मिल जाएगी। ठीक है, चलिए शुरू करते हैं। आज हम पढ़ेंगे सेमी इम्पेरिकल मास फॉर्मूला। अब सेमी इम्पेरिकल का मतलब क्या होता है? इसका मतलब होता है कि ऐसा फॉर्मूला जो ना एक थ्योरी पे बेस्ड नहीं हो, जो एक्सपेरिमेंटली प्राप्त वैल्यूज पे आधारित फॉर्मूला हो, उसे सेमी इम्पेरिकल कहते हैं। और बाइंडिंग एनर्जी के लिए फॉर्मूला कहलाता है सेमी इम्पेरिकल मास फॉर्मूला। For binding energy, a given nucleus Jxa is. For volume energy, suppose we have a atom and atom have a nucleus. Okay, we assume that the nucleus is a spherical and the spherical volume is AV. The volume is V, and for the volume coefficient for the binding energy is AV, and A is the atomic mass. Okay, the binding energy for the volume energy is AVA, same as for the surface. You know, a sphere has a surface and nucleus has not a bound surface. You know, we have proton and neutrons, and the proton and neutrons are distributed over the volume, and the density of the nucleus at the center is highest, and when we go away from the center, the density going decrease. Just like that. See, this is the density at the center, and when we go through surface, then this is going to this like this. So this is not the bound surface. So for this, the surface, the binding energy, overall binding energy decrease because of surface. Okay, so there is this because the minus sign is here. Okay, and this is proportional to AF A to power 2 by 3. Okay, we know 4 pi r square, and r is for the nucleus, R is R naught A to power 1 by 3. And we put it here. This is 4 pi R naught is AS and A to power 1 by 3. So this is the surface term. Okay. Now next. You know, the nucleus has charge and Coulombic charge. Okay. What is Coulomb force? F is equal to K Q1 Q2 upon R square. Okay. What is energy? Potential energy K Q upon R. Okay. For the nucleus, energy is proportional to 1 by R. Okay. Because of nuclear charge, the surface energy will decrease. Okay, so for the nuclear charge, we have term this z minus 1 a to power divided by a to power 1 by 3. Okay, this is for Coulombic term. Minus asymmetric. For the symmetry, like suppose we have a atom, okay, and we have proton and neutrons. The suppose these are equal. Proton n are, proton and neutron are equal, then this term go to zero. Suppose the proton is less than neutrons, then we left the neutrons, much more neutrons, and we have energy like this. And we left electrons, neutrons, neutrons. So the due to neutrons, the symmetry of nucleus gonna change. So because of asymmetry of neutrons and proton numbers, we got binding energy. Okay. So this is for this is for the symmetry of nucleus. This is n minus z to power 2 divided by a, or this is coefficient for symmetry. Now because of parity, we have this term, okay, ap 1 divided by a to power 3 by 4. We now discuss this for in further. First term, the volume energy term, which is equal to EV equal to AVA, amount of energy required in transform a liquid to its vapor state. What does that mean? That means we have a nucleus. Suppose we have a liquid drop. Okay. Now we give to energy it, and it convert to vapor. So this energy is required to convert it into a vapor. This energy is called volume energy. Okay. And this is equal to this. EVA, and EV per atom, yeah, per nuclear mass, this is, we left the coefficient of energy, volume energy term, and this is almost equal to 14 mega electro volt. Now, this is constant for all, and this is value from experimental, not a theoretical, okay. We do the lots of experiment and we got this value. Okay, now we go for surface term. Now the energy required to surface, energy due to surface is this As a to power 2 by 3. Surface effect being similar to surface tension in liquid. Surface, suppose we have a liquid drop, and a liquid drop have a surface tension due to the free molecules. Suppose this is the surface of drop. Now this atom is have force this direction and this direction, but this direction have no force. So surface trying to go away from here in this direction. This is called the tension. This is called the surface tension, and similar it happen in nucleus. So due to this tension, this is energy is this. Es upon per atomic mass is As upon a to power 1 by 3. Now next term. Next term is Coulombic energy term. This is equal to E AC ZZ minus 1 divided by A to power 1 by 3. This term defines the Coulombic repulsion between the uniformly distributed proton. In nucleus, we have proton, lots of protons. They have charge plus 1, and due to this plus charge repulsion, we got this energy. Okay, and this repulsion decreases the binding energy, that decreases the stability of nucleus. Or stability is equal to proportional binding energy. Okay, because how binding energy jitni jyada hogi utni hi jyada atom stable hoga. Okay, next, and this is equal, this constant AC is equal to 0.5 mega electrovolt. Okay, next term, asymmetry term. What is asymmetry term? Just a second. We have term this asymmetry term. EA is equal to EF, you can say S, you can say A minus 2 Z to power 2 divided by A due to unique number of neutron and proton based on fully exclusive principle. Okay, and this A is equal to 19 mega electrovolt. The all values of constants are experimental values. Okay, next page. Now, parity term, energy term. This is equal to E to power EP. E is equal to AP divided by A to power minus 1 by 4. And this is equal to AP is equal to almost 34 mega electrovolt. Okay. Now, EP is depend number of neutron and proton. Okay, now when the number of proton and neutron are even, then this term going to plus 34 mega electrovolt, and this going to odd, then this is minus, in minus, and this is there is 35 mega electrovolt. When this is odd, even E or even odd, then this is equal to zero. This term will not contribute in binding energy. Now, application of semi-empirical mass formula. The application is, first of all, binding energy. Due to binding energy, we can calculate the mass of atom. The atomic mass hum calculate kar sakte hain. Okay, and how the binding energy, this due to proton, neutron and atom. and for the mass of atom, this is equal to Zmp plus neutron plus minus binding energy. You know, the separated neutron and proton energy is greater than the atom's energy. So the binding energy term in will be minus. Okay. Now the second application is nuclear mass. We can calculate nuclear mass due to binding energy. This mass, binding energy due to proton, neutron minus atom mass, and in energy term we multiply to c square. Okay, and this is become in nuclear mass. Okay, next, chalte. Just a second. Okay. Q value of alpha decay. Now, Q value when atom decay into atom decay alpha molecule, then the equation is this, you know, the alpha as helium atom, alpha is helium atom with two proton and two neutron, then this equation become this. Okay, plus when atom decay, then energy will in release, then this term plus this plus Q will we get. Next page. Now this Q is equal to this Q will equal to mass of atom minus mass of daughter atom minus alpha atom. Okay. Now Q value is always positive. Alpha decay will occur, and when all Q value is negative, alpha will not occur because a atom is stable. A atom is unstable because of high neutron. The atom wants to stable, then he will decrease atomic energy, and when the atomic energy decrease, that we release alpha particle. Okay, so Q value will always positive. Now Q value for beta decay. Now beta decay is also two kinds. When beta negative and beta positive. Beta negative is neutron convert into proton plus electron. Okay. You can remember this negative comes neutron, and neutrons come electrons, and this positive. So you can make short tricks with negative neutron, negative electron, like this. Okay, so this for this beta negative emission, yes, you can say electron emission, because neutron convert into proton plus electron, then you can also say electron emission. And this is equal to this atom convert into plus a one proton, and here is also plus one. Okay. Plus electron plus energy. Now, beta decays occur when the atom's energy is high. Okay. Now, beta positive decay. You can see the equations for beta Q. Mass of, in mass term, mass of atom minus mass of daughter atom minus mass of electron. Okay. Now, atomic mass is always greater than daughter mass. Okay. Now, beta plus decay. You can say positron emission. Beta plus decay is the proton convert into neutron plus positron. The atom convert into daughter atom plus with a positron plus release energy for this beta Q. Q beta positive is equal to mass of atom minus mass of daughter atom plus mass of neutron, mass of electron, positron. Positron mass of positron is equal to mass of electron. Everything is equal to electron, just for only different is charge. The positron charge is plus and electron charge is negative. Okay. And same as beta negative, the mass of atom always greater than mass of daughter atom. Okay. Charge radius of mirror nuclei. What is mirror nuclei? Mirror nuclei is, we have X and Y atom. What is X and Y. And X has, suppose 3, 4 proton or neutron. X has 3 proton, 4 neutron, and Y has 4 neutron, 4 proton, 3 neutron. This kind of nuclei is called mirror nuclei. Okay. And Z minus, Z1 minus Z1 is 1 equal to 1 for mirror nuclei that is greater than Z2. Next page. For the mirror nuclei, the equation become Mp proton minus mass of neutron plus Coulombic term, because Coulombic term is different. The Coulombic term is EC. Is equal to AC ZZ minus 1 A to power 1 by 3. Now AC is 3 by 5 E to power 2 upon 4 pi epsilon naught R naught. Okay. Now delta E is equal to 3 by 4 1 by 4 upon epsilon naught E square upon R, and where we put the value of Z1 square minus Z2 square. Okay. Now Z1 square minus Z2 square we can write in like this. This. And AC is equal to EC is equal to AC A to power 2 by 3. Coulombic energy difference. This is called Coulombic energy difference. And delta M is proportional to A to power 2 by 3. Now, mass parabola and stability of isobars. By semi-empirical mass formula. Let me rough. Now we have binding energy. By semi-empirical mass formula, the Zm mass of atom is equal to mass of proton plus mass of neutron plus binding energy minus binding energy. Binding energy is from semi-empirical mass formula. Binding energy is AVA plus AS A to power 2 by 3 plus SC ZZ minus 1 upon A to power 1 by 3 plus due to symmetry and due to parity. Okay. Now, for the stability, we calculate DM DZ. DM DZ and put the value in this. For the stability, we know that del M upon del Z is equal to 0, and the value of DM upon DZ we put the value on this equation, and we get this one. A curve between, and this equation is parabola equation. Okay. The curve between M and Z give a parabola. Okay. This equation is parabola equation. Most stable isobar when del M del Z is equal to 0 and Z equal to minus beta divided by 2A. Okay. Next page. When A is odd, that means del is equal to 0. Del A is equal to odd Z, yeah, even N, yeah, even Z odd N. these are probability of going odd A. When we get only one parabola. Okay. And parabola equation is alpha A plus beta Z plus gamma Z square. Now this is the parabola equation. We have the atoms here, here and here, three atoms, this and this. Now the atom come from here to here, then the atom occur beta minus, and atom come from here to here, this will occur beta positive. And most stable isobar is the bottom one, because bottom one has lowest energy. So this is the stable isobar. Then A is even. We getting even, we have two way, odd odd and even even. In odd neutron, odd even neutron, even positron, then we get even A. And del will be negative, del can be positive. And in this way we get two or three parabolas for even and for odd A. This is the diagram for even and odd. Well, this is for odd and this is for even. Now even is more stable than odd. Okay, and the most stable is isobar is even. The vertical mass difference going to delta to delta. Now this is delta and this is delta, then difference will be 2 delta. Okay. One is minus delta, one is plus delta, and difference will be 2 delta. Number of parabolas equal to number of stable isobar. If we have two parabolas, we get three stable isobars. Two parabola, two stable. Three parabola, three stable isobars. Okay. Now we go to the next page. Next page have the questions. Now we solve the questions. The first question is the difference in the Coulomb energy between the mirror nuclei and this mirror nuclei. This nucleus and this is 6 mega electron volt. Assuming that the nucleus have a spherically symmetric charge distribution and the E square is approximately 1 mega electron volt for me. The radius of the magnesium nucleus is. Now, delta E for the Coulombic interaction is this. 3 by 5 e to power 2 upon 4 pi epsilon naught r into a to power 2 by 3. And this is given to us 1 mega electro volt. Okay. And the difference is given 6 mega electro volt. Okay. 6 mega electro volt is equal to 3 by 5 into 1 mega electro volt into A upon R Fermi. Okay. we put the r is equal to r naught a to power 1 by 3. Okay, this one. And we get the r is a upon 10 and a is 49. Then r is equal to 4.9 into 10 to the power minus 15 meter. Okay. Now, next question. Next question, the binding energy of a light nuclei joined A in mega electrovolt is given by the formula, approximate formula, B is equal to almost 16 a minus 20 a to power 2 by 3 minus 3 by 4 z square a to power minus 1 by 3 plus 30 n minus z to power 2 divided by a, where n is equal to a minus z is the neutron number. The value of z of the most stable isobar for the given a, we have to find the value of a. Okay. For the most stable isobar, we have to do delta B divided by delta Z is equal to 0. Then we get the lowest energy has the most stable isobar. Okay. When we differentiate the equation, then we get this equation 6 by 4 z a to the power minus 1 by 3 plus 30 by a to the power a minus 2 by 2 z minus into minus 2 is equal to 0. Now we get the 6 common and z by 4 a to the power minus 1 by 3 plus 20 by a minus 2z, this is equal to 0. Z by 4 a to the power minus 1 by 3 minus 40 z upon a is equal to minus 20. And we put out the minus 40 z by a is equal to minus 1 by 160 a to the power minus 2 by 3 is equal to this. And now z equal to this, z is equal to a divided by 2, 1 minus a to the power 2 by 3 divided by 1 by 6 inverse. Okay. Next page. Let ES denoted the contribution of the surface energy per nucleon in a liquid drop model. The ratio of energy E for the aluminium, for E for the zinc. Now ES is equal to surface energy per nucleon. We told that surface energy per nucleon is equal to surface energy AS a to power 2 by 3 divided by per nucleon A, and this is equal to AS a to power minus 1 by 3. We put the values for aluminium and zinc there. For the aluminium A is 27, for the zinc is 64, and we get 3 by 4 inverse. Now this is equal to 4 by 3 r, 4 ratio 3. And the B option is correct. The next question. The next question is, for the nucleic mass, for the nucleic mass number A is 125, the bending energy calculated from the liquid rope model is maximum for using AC 0.7 mega electrovolt and asymmetric is 22.5 mega electrovolt. Now the binding energy is equal to the surface volume term, surface term, column term, symmetry term and parity term. And this is this. And for the minimum value, this is equal to 0. Delta B divided by delta Z is equal to this. And this is no Z, then this is equal to 0, this is become this is become this, and this is also become 0. Let's see. Now, this is, we put the, we got this value, minus 2 AC Z divided by A to power 1 by 3 plus AC divided by A to power 1 by 3 plus 4 asymmetric minus A to power 8 asymmetric divided by A into Z is equal to 0. We put the values for AC and asymmetric, then minus 2 into AC is equal to 0.7 Z to Z, and A is 125, then 125, 0.7 divided by 125 to power 1 by 3 plus 4 into asymmetric. Asymmetric is 2.5 minus 8 into 2.5 divided by 1 by 150 into Z is equal to 0. Now the values of Z being this is, you can calculate with calculators, and you got the Z is equal to 52. You PDF aapko description mein mil jayegi, so don't worry about the calculations. Question number third. The question is, if the binding energy of nucleus is given by this equation, semi empirical mass formula, delta, here delta is 0, parent, where AV given, AS given, asymmetric given, AC given, then the Z for the most stable isobar of four nucleus with A is 216. Now you know the most stable isobar, we calculate minimum energy, minimum for the minimum delta B upon delta Z going to be 0. Now this equation become this when we differentiate it, partially differentiate with Z, then this is equal to 0 minus 0 minus asymmetry, here is no value of Z, so 0 0, here is 2z, here is z, then this minus, here is also a z term, then this is equal to this. Now we put the values of asymmetric asymmetric ac this value, and here is z. So pen is not working properly today. This is Z. Okay. 96 into 2 z upon a minus 1 plus 1.5 z divided by 6 is equal to 0. Now this is equal to 8 upon 9, 8 upon 9 z plus 1.5 divided by 6 z. There is no a, there is z. Z is equal to 96. Here is Z. Okay. Now this equation becomes 8 divided by 9 plus 1.5 divided by 6 is equal to into Z is equal to 96. Now this equals this become 1 by 4. 8 divided by 9 plus 1 by 4 is 96, and we calculate into Z, we forget here Z, and Z become Z into 22 plus 9 upon 36 into 96, and Z equal to this, and Z almost be equal to 84. Okay, that's all for guys. Video pasand aaya ho to like karna, apne physics doston ke saath share karna, aur channel ko subscribe zarur kare taki hum aise hi aur video aage dalte rahe. Thank you. Dhanyavaad. Have a nice day.